What's up guys, Pixel Sammy here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use a zoom transition in a different way, in such a way that no one has ever seen before. And by using this method you can stand out in the crowd and stand aside from the crowd and make your videos different from everybody else, because we all know that zoom transition is used by almost everybody in the world who is into videography and all. So I'm going to show you a small trick which is a bit different, a bit cooler than before, and it will help you uplift your videography skills a lot. So with that being said, let's jump right into Final Cut Pro. So this is the footage without any transition or effects. So this is what it looks with the transition and the other effect. So it is pretty simple, I am just adding a bit rotation in this clip, but it is a bit tricky also. So first what we are going to do is, we are going to add a simple smooth zoom in transition. I have already created one, the link is in the bio, you guys know the drill, just go to the link down below. And then drag the zoom transition onto these clips. Let it render. Then play it. Okay, I'm just going to change a bit of clips from here to here, and I'm going to just increase the speed and make sure that there is only a little bit gap between the two clips or between the two transitions. Means the whole footage with the transition should be very small in timing, because the faster it is, the better it looks. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to compound the clip by clicking Alt plus G. Then go to the effects. And change the scale to 50%. And then make a compound clip again. Then go to the effects panel and search Pixel Sammy Mirror In. And the link is in the bio, you guys know the drill as well. The download link is in the bio. Then in the effects panel, set the width to 960 and set the height to 540. And how did I get this effect? 960 is 1920x2 and height is 1080x2, which is 540, and the other one is 960. And if you are using 4K clips, you can just divide the resolution by 2 and set the height and the width. The reason why we are doing this is because when we are going to rotate it, there will be some space on the edges, the black spaces. So in order to remove those black spaces, we are going to use this effect. And then set the scale to 200% so that it gets back to normal. Now go to the rotation and set a keyframe at the start of the clip, and go to the end, set a keyframe again and set the rotation to as much as you want, or as much as you want it to rotate. Like I have set it around 360. You can set it around 720 or any other which you feel like. Now let it render. Here it is. Compound this clip again. Okay, so now what we are going to do is, we are going to place the letterbox effect so that it gets the cinematic bars, and to make it look more cinematic, we are going to use the letterbox effect. So we are just placing the adjacent layer and then search in letterbox in the effects panel and go to the inspector panel and set the aspect ratio to 2.55:1, and then you will get a letterbox effect. And a bonus tip for all of you, we are going to add a little bit of bleach effect or the RGB effect on this, and there are no plugins in for this. You just need to search in prism in the effects panel and drag and drop it onto the clip, and then you can set the amount from 16 to more or less which you feel like, and set the angle also. So that is pretty much it guys, thank you so much for watching my video, and I hope this video will help you make better videos and better content. And if you want to tag me in your videos, you can share them on Instagram, you can DM me your doubts, or you can DM me your footages also. I would like to see what kind of footages you guys come up with with these effects I teach. If you guys have any doubt, you can always approach me in Instagram or any other place. So with that being said, if you are into cinematography, photography, filmmaking and all those other stuff, then my channel is just for you. And if you like my content, then consider subscribing to my channel and press the bell button so that you guys get notified every time I make a new video. So with that being said, this is Pixel Sammy signing out. Peace out.